review time, partner.
And I'm going to show you how to win the climate change debate every single time. Some of you say climate change. You mean global warming? Don't matter. You're going to find out. There are many common beliefs about what climate change actually is. This is a problem that is specific to this current generation due to the technological advances that are supposedly the cause. There's a high amount of activism going on about stopping man-made climate change. But I'm going to show you why this is a waste of time. Climate change and global warming are not the same things. Let's look at the definitions. Based on Global Warming, the Unabridged Guide, global warming is the rise in the average temperature of Earth's atmosphere and oceans since the late 19th century and its projected continuation. This rise in temperature is due to the activities of humans, and that is from a 95% consensus from scientists on a UN panel. In short, the definition of global warming is that the actions of humans are causing the Earth to get hotter, and it will eventually lead to the end of the Earth. It is not the same thing as climate change. Climate change is something that has been going on since the beginning of time. It is the natural fluctuation of the Earth's climate. We don't have any control of it. For example, who caused the Ice Age? Was it the dinosaurs? Who brought us out of the Ice Age? Was it the first human settlers that caused the Earth to thaw by their smoke signals and campfires, harming the ozone layer? If you think about it longer than 2 minutes, you will realize it's not likely. The first claim I will debunk is this. Cow flatulence is causing the ozone layer to open and cause global warming. Now, many of you feel that this is just a ridiculous claim that I'm making up. If only that was the case. You see, the White House believes it. See, the White House wants to regulate cow farts. Vaccines are even being developed to decrease the amount of greenhouse gases being emitted. Greenhouse gases, I'm talking about cattle flatulence. Australian farmers are even signing their sheep and cattle up to get vaccinated for this purpose. Now, let's use some common sense here. If cow or cattle flatulence is so dangerous to this planet, what happened when the dinosaurs were around? Oh yeah, see, dinosaurs are said to have roamed the planet for 165 million years. Over the span of 165 million years, you can safely figure that the accumulated population of dinosaurs exceeds that of cows and other cattle of this present time. You can also safely figure that dinosaurs are multiple times more massive than cows and any other animal on this planet. We can look at the recent discovery of the titanosaur for this reference. Titanosaur is said to be the largest animal to ever walk the planet. The point I'm making here is that dinosaurs would have emitted more greenhouse gases than cows due to their gargantuan size. They would also have emitted more gas over a time of 165 million years. According to the original claim, this should have caused many massive holes in the ozone layer. As you can see, the Earth is not in a ball of flames. And not only that, but we had an ice age, didn't we? We should have had an extremely hot age with those high amount of global warming causing factors, but we didn't. Simply put, the ice age we had was natural climate change. You gotta understand that. This climate change happens without the actions of humans. Then another point you must understand, how did we get out of the ice age? Surely it was not because of campfires from settlers emitting gases into the ozone layer. The second claim is that human-caused global warming is causing the polar bears to almost go extinct. Some of them even saying they're going extinct. The idea is that global warming is melting the polar ice caps and is destroying their environment. This is causing them to die and even eat each other. Isn't that horrible? The polar bear has been the mascot for the cause of global warming for many years. But when looking at the numbers, the claims just don't add up. And then you can even see the pictures. They show you those sad little pictures. Oh, look, this polar bear right here. He is on the last piece of ice. Let's look at these numbers. In the 1950s, it was reported that there are 5,000 to 10,000 living polar bears in the world. Let's look in 2014. In the year 2014, it is reported that there are 22,600 to 32,000 living polar bears on the planet. That is four times the amount from the 1950s. Oh, it looks like the polar bears are doing all right. As far as their habitat is concerned, let's look at that. In 2007, Al Gore spoke intensely about scientific research he has seen and predicted the entire North Polar ice caps will vanish in 5 years. Well, if we look at the data from 2013, we see that the polar ice caps are still there and they have increased from the last year. The third claim is that we actually have to do something to stop global warming. There are billions of dollars being spent and solutions being created to stop global warming. Politicians are making speeches about going green by using wind and solar so we can cut down the carbon emissions. This sounds nice, and I would love to have every home powered by solar panels. But if this is solely because of global warming, then there's a problem. Global warming has been on a 17-year plus pause. According to NASA, it has been 17 years and 6 months. Now, if we bring that up to date, we would see it's been 17 years and 9 months. This is startling information considering the growth of the population. More people means more carbon emissions going into the atmosphere. This means we should see more global warming. More global warming would bring a hotter Earth, and we would see a continual increase in temperature every year. This has not been the case with this 17-year pause. And we can look here. This is the chart. No global warming for 17 years and 9 months. Okay, stop looking at the text. Let's actually look at the chart. Temperatures going up, temperatures going down. This is from 1997 to 2014. Let me move this up for y'all. How do you explain this? Goes up, one down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Now, if it was global warming, it should do like this. Look at the little arrow. It's going up. Uh-oh, it's going up. It's still going up. Oh my gosh, it's going up, y'all. That's what global warming looks like. Not this. Not this indecisive up and down for no reason. Well, there is a reason. It's just regular climate change. And then we look here, this little ugly old chart, blurry as heck. Okay, absolutely no warming since 1998. Less than 1 degree warming since 1978. Look at this chart. You guys are running around talking about global warming. Oh, we got to watch out. We got to go green. You better buy that green bag. What? You know, they get the charts and then they say, look at this. Look, it went down. It's down and then it just went up. It's one little part of the chart and it gets you scared. It's off the charts, guys. It's off the scale. Then you move it back, you see. No global warming for 17 years and 9 months. Get on somewhere with that. And then you talk, remember, emphasis. Less than 1 degrees? Really? Let's look at the computer models. A lot of people think computers gonna take over the world. Probably no time soon with the way they acting with this. Well, especially with this. The computer models were wrong. You see all these little scribbles? Look like color pencils, maybe crayons. Definitely color pencils. Look here, look at the reality. Reality is this right here. It's where we at. What they predicted is all this. Way off. That's 44 of the latest climate models. Yeah, let's look at this one. The catastrophic errors. How 36 out of the 38 most important climate computers forecast doom that never was. There they go again with all them little crayon colors. The colored lines. The world's most respected computer forecast of our planet's temperature since 1980. The black line. The real recorded temperature showing how predictions which dictated world green policies got it so monumentally wrong. Former NASA scientist Dr. Roy Spencer says the climate models used by government agencies to create policies have failed miserably. Spencer analyzed 90 climate models against surface temperature and satellite temperature data and found that more than 95% of the models have over forecast the warming trend since 1979. Well, dang, doggone it. We just saw two charts and then we see this right here. Look at this. We already know the deal. The little colored pencil, crayon looking stuff. Let's bring it back to the point. We should be seeing a continual increase in temperature every year since we are seeing an increase in continual supposed global warming causing factors. We have more cars on the road than ever. According to a study by Ward's Auto, the population of cars on the road is over 1 billion. What happened there, guys? And if you haven't noticed, we have experienced record-breaking cold temperatures recently around the world. It recently snowed in Egypt for the first time in 112 years. Yeah, look at that. Does that look like something that would happen during global warming? No.
The fourth claim
is that global warming is actually climate change. Global warming is not climate change. The global warming definition is specifically specified as the increase in Earth's temperature due to the UV rays beaming through the holes in the ozone layer. The holes in the ozone layer are supposed to be caused by the actions of humans. Climate change is the Earth's natural cycle of changing. One example of that would be the Ice Age. The only reason why you hear global warming is causing climate change is because those who originally proposed global warming is real couldn't back up their claims that humans are causing the Earth to get hotter. It didn't make sense to continue making their claims in an alarming manner if we are on the receiving end of record cold temperatures. It just don't sound right. They had to come up with a way to justify spending billions of dollars. They tried to do this by saying global warming is causing the polar vortex. The explanation of this is that the damages to the ozone layer are causing the Earth to act unnatural, and the polar vortex is causing the record cold temperatures. There are recent articles claiming to show effects of the polar vortex with Niagara Falls being frozen over. Only problem with this is that in 1974, Time magazine claimed that the polar vortex was caused due to global cooling. That's right, the complete opposite of global warming. We can also look back as far as 1911 and see that this is not the first time Niagara Falls has frozen over. Let's look at Time magazine over the times. We see here Time magazine talking about the cooling of America. People in here sitting in the house looking at a fireplace on TV. Cold as heck. Then we see here Time magazine talking about global warming. Cooking eggs on a pan. Then we see Special Report Time magazine. Be worried. Be very worried about global warming. Or should we be worried? Very worried about the big freeze with this Rush Limbaugh looking joker with a chart in his hand. What is the chart talking about? Oh yeah. What's going on here is they are reacting to the weather. They're not reacting to the big freeze. They're not really reacting to global warming. They wouldn't be doing this if they understood that natural climate change is going to happen regardless. Let's look at the fifth claim. The fifth claim is that there is a 95% consensus that humans cause global warming. With this consensus claim, you may also hear about a 97%, 98%, and even a 99% consensus. Many of those who agree with that claim would say, I'm disagreeing with science in general. How can you disagree with science? They would have you believe that the 95% to 97% or whatever percentage they are using at the moment represents all scientists. These claims come from the likes of John Oliver all the way to Barack Obama. You think I'm lying? Well, let's look at this recent claim from John Oliver. Video that got millions of views. John Oliver brings up all these scientists against this one skeptic of global warming. And then you get Bill Nye somewhere over there. And he claims that the overwhelming view of the entire scientific community is that global warming is caused by humans. We can also see here Obama agrees. 97% of scientists agree. Climate change is real, man-made, and dangerous. You see that? Look at that. Scientists. How are you going to disagree with all scientists? And you even see here, Cenk from Young Turks. I used to say that the 98% of the world scientists agree that global warming is real and man-made. It turns out it's a little over 99.8%. Really? We can look at Michio Kaku, the physicist. Climate change is the 800-pound gorilla in the living room that the media dances around. But in the scientific community, it's a settled question. You see that? It's settled. 95% of scientists believe this is happening. With 100% confidence, temperatures are rising. Wow. He said, settled question, one. 95%, remember that. Then he said, 100% confidence, temperatures are rising. We already been through that. We saw the temperatures are not rising, but whatever. Where are they getting this from? Because when we look closer, we will see that these claims are not true. Majority of scientists do not agree with man-made climate change. See, that original claim of a 95% consensus agreeing on human-caused global warming comes from a UN panel. They are specifically known as the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. the IPCC, and it is often claimed that there are 4,000 scientists who reviewed the reports. You should know that the 4,000 scientists did not write the report, and the 4,000 scientists didn't review the report. And when you take out the duplicated names, it takes the number down to less than 2,900. The reports are not always peer-reviewed, and many of those scientists are decades away from receiving their PhD. Some of those same graduate students were made lead and contributing authors on the IPCC reports. And those are supposed to be your top experts. Another red flag is that there are authors of the assessment reports who are green activists with WWF connections. That's the World Wildlife Fund. The popular belief is that the consensus is from those who are unbiased. Knowing this information, I find that hard to believe. See, they only want to appear neutral to gain your trust. Another reason why people are saying that there is a 97% consensus is because they heard it on the news. And some who would call themselves doing research will look at this other study from the AGU, that's the American Geophysical Union, survey. Now, this is not a peer-reviewed report, but an online survey that was sent out to 10,257 people. It was only received by 3,146 people, and 77 out of those were climate scientists. 75 of the 77 agreed with the second question of the two-question survey. That's how they got their little 97% consensus stuff. Here are the two questions. When compared with the pre-1800s levels, do you think that mean global temperatures have generally risen, fallen, or remained relatively constant? That's number one. Number two is, do you think human activity is a significant contributing factor in changing mean global temperatures? That's right. The 97% consensus point comes from a two-question online survey. Only 75 climate scientists agreed with the second question. That's embarrassing considering the survey was created to bump up the numbers since it was an online survey with only two questions. And those pushing the global warming hoax bring up the consensus point without giving you the full detail because they know how ridiculous it will sound. There is no way 75 scientists represents the whole scientific community. And we could even look at the IPCC panel claim of 95% out of the quote unquote 4,000 people. And C is not representative of the whole scientific community. There's a simple way to destroy this. Look, in the U.S. alone, there were over 10 million scientists and engineers in the workforce in 1999. Now, if you can find the number of scientists in the world, you will see that it greatly exceeds the 4,077 representative number that they keep using. And I'm just being nice by putting both studies added together. Some of y'all might argue about the difference between an engineer and scientist according to the 10 million I mentioned earlier. See, that's just to give you an idea. What you can actually do is you can compare the number of scientific journals being created. As you see here, we can do it from each country. Millions are being created. Now, you can be sure that 4,000 people aren't creating all these documents. Look at all these different countries. No. They want you to believe this small amount represents the entire scientific community. Why? They've never polled the whole scientific community. It's a complete joke. Consider this. The scientific community is made up of millions of people. Look, we got to count for the scientists in the U.S. We got to count for the scientists in China. We got to count for them in Russia, India, etc. We're talking about millions of people here. They are not represented in their little surveys. So listen to this. 95% of the scientific community does not agree with human-caused global warming.